Hydropower plants generate lots of power and sometimes excessive noise. For employees working inside the power plants, harmful noise levels can cause problems.
In the last 10 years, Reclamation has spent over $5 million in hearing loss claims.
Among the Bureau of Reclamation's 53 hydropower plants, some built more than half a century ago, noise was not factored into plant design. Instead, the power industry relies on earplugs and earmuffs to guard against hearing loss in noisy environments.
You know, it's not just the noise. When you're in there all day, it's the percussions and the vibrations that at the end of the day will mentally exhaust you.
Reclamation's Research and Development Office in Denver, Colorado is working with the Office of Naval Research and a private acoustic design firm to deploy noise dampening technologies to reduce power plant noise levels.
It's an important way that we can protect our employees, protect their hearing, and as our plants age, we perform rehabilitations and include noise reduction in those rehabilitation programs.
In U.S. submarines stationed across the globe, the Office of Naval Research has successfully used noise suppression technologies in engine rooms since the 1970s.
They put a lot of money into making sure that a submarine is very quiet, so their engine rooms are really similar to maybe a hydropower plant. We just thought that there might be a partnership relationship there, and sure enough it was.
The pilot project, begun in 2013, targets three Reclamation power plants. The aim is to isolate sound and improve the environment for power plant workers. They've uncovered some surprising results.
In general, we've been able to reduce noise in some locations to as much as 15 decibels.
And more than that, the employees are calmer, and it's a work environment that they don't feel as much anxiety. It's a calmer place to work since they spend hours every day in that environment.
Noise control engineers like Jeff Comrauer say that most power plants have hard concrete walls that magnify sound. Much like a submarine engine room, these sound waves need a place to go.
And what happens is that energy doesn't go anywhere, it just bounces off the walls, and that tends to increase the noise levels even way above the source.
To capture the noise profile and target even the subtlest reverberations, Comrauer performed acoustic surveys using cutting-edge analytical equipment to isolate hazardous noise sources. The equipment looks like it came straight out of the film Star Wars.
And it's officially known as the Death Star. It's essentially a globe that's got 36 microphones in it, and it's also got a camera in it that rotates. And what it does is it rotates around, takes about 500 to 600 pictures, and creates a 3D picture of the space.
Comrauer's Death Star, or acoustic holography array, measured noise levels and developed noise profiles for generator rooms at three power plants, Rosa, Chandler, and Green Springs. Each site had unique characteristics and noise abatement solutions.
And then you sit at stationary, you take an acoustical measurement, and because you have the 36 microphones, the sound from different areas or from a particular location hits each of those microphones at a slightly different time. And the software allows you to take that time delay and do like a transformation, and you can overlay where the acoustical hotspots are on top of the picture to validate what you could probably figure out using engineering judgment where the source is actually coming from.
At Rosa Power Plant in Yakima, Washington, the challenge was to locate the most aggravating source.
I would say that Rosa, on average, was a fairly noisy small plant, especially with the exhaust fans running.
There was, of course, a direct noise from the generator. However, in that plant, there are two large cooling fans that are mounted up on a wall that actually created a lot more acoustical energy in that space than the generator.
Once the area was identified, acoustic engineers found a solution that absorbed sound and reduced the hearing hazard.
So in Rosa, we work with a vendor designed silencers that went right in front of the fans to lower the energy coming into the space. And then we treated the reverberant situation. It was all concrete, highly reverberant, so we put tuned absorbers, essentially acoustical panels, that have a metal facing that's perforated with some sound absorption material in back of it, and that cut down the bouncing of the sound and reduced the overall level in the plant significantly, and we got about a 5 or 6 dB reduction in that plant, very successful.
Rosa was a huge improvement. In fact, all three plants were a major improvement. You know, I mean, pretty much got all the main, with the exception of the turbine pits, we got them below the 85 decibel range. The Green Springs plant was actually so loud at the control station in the plant that you couldn't use the phone. And it is now down under 80, no hearing protection required. You can have a normal conversation. The vibration and percussions were drastically reduced. With the new sound baffles in, you can't even hear them run. They're extremely quiet. With the sound absorption material on the walls, it took a lot of the vibration out of the plant. It's a lot calmer place to be. Everything, with the exception of the turbine pit, we were able to reduce and get below 85 decibels.
The research and development group hope their results can be applied to all power plants. They expect hearing loss claims will be reduced significantly.
This technology just isn't applicable at Reclamation hydropower plants. It's applicable at all hydropower plants across the industry, around the world. And it's a real way to emphasize safety to our staff and the culture as a whole.